Boy, that play. I'm glad I had that play in my fucking playbook. That shit, a door knocker. For real, for real. 39 yards there, a big one.
So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10.
And it's funny because even playing him, I'm still not trying. Like, I'm actually still running plays to feel comfortable with my offense. I don't do nothing for a reason. That's the reason why I'm up this early. I'm up for a reason. I have to learn how to produce a drive without having to sell my hand. And I know in the leagues, unless shit happen that don't normally happen, plays get made that don't normally, you know, that don't normally transpire regularly. It's just I have to learn my way of being able to not have to make an excuse for what happened. Like, to be honest. A terrific opening drive has them knocking on the door, first and goal. This shit don't even be a game for me and them. It be a mirror match for me and myself to see what I'm, timing a bit off that time as that one falls to the ground. I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into. I know if I pull out that four house, really nigga's gonna be like that. This is like, it's basically like go again here from the 10-yard line on second and goal. Now Stafford, he's gonna change things up. So I was wondering if I did it like this and kind of like moved him to the side to where it's a regular formation. Just me working on shit. To be honest, thank you for selling in touchdown. That shit look like it's gonna be nice too. So I'll come out in four house, move my tight end to the right side, and then run the play to the right side. And this is exactly the reason why I'm doing it. Brandon, when you're the defensive team in the first drive of the game, you give up a touchdown. The key is not to get down. Make those adjustments and come back for your next series with the intent. It'd be me challenging myself. And I don't know if you noticed, I was really running plays all yesterday, after that, trying to find trying to find my way. And of course, with each person you play, the shit gonna be different. It's not different opponents, different outcome.
The touchdown, here's Marr to kick it away.
Yeah, I've been up since 7. Michael wake up still believing she got to go to school. To move this out to the 25-yard line. I thought I'd move this from my playbook. I could have swore I'd move that from my playbook, but I'll go back and do it again. Herbert's gonna lead up the Chargers here, first and 10. Now, this is the set time. Niggas like him. I like niggas like him. Yep. He trying to free up Keenan Allen. Thank you. Thank you. And a short pick up to about the 27. It'll be second down. Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about the step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving. Watch your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 16 yards is the pickup. I had to take that package out last night. I had my man blitzing up the hole. They let the nigga run straight through the hole. I was like, yeah, this package ain't shit. Scan the field, and here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup. Meanwhile, Herbert's throw there because everybody go to play. And he gets this to the other side of midfield across the 45. You know what I really want to do? Get back to the way I played on the old man. It's like, and when I say that, I mean like, I will fuck a nigga up with some of the most simple plays, and I'm gonna try this next drive. Justin Herbert looking to pass. We're not gonna lose this game. They bring him down. So now 20 yards to go on second down after the sack. Work to be done. Herbert. Make it throw to him. on the outside pass. Now let's see if it works. This now is when I get a chance to see if the fucking formation works.
That's a good bounce back play right there after taking a sack on first down. Didn't quite get it to the marker, but now they're in a much better spot for a third and short yardage call. If you're the offensive coordinator, you like
looking at that. Gotcha. Oh, it do work. It worked. Worked very well.
It'll be a loss of 8 on the sack, and it's going to lead him to fourth down. So now make that a second sack for them on this drive.
And Brandon, we hear it every week when we go out to do a game. Everyone talks about playing complimentary football. Their offense goes down and scores. They see that, and they want to back them up. And that they
so,
did, getting two sacks on this
Rand,
drive.
Playing against niggas with the weird shit.
That's not they're going to go for it on fourth down and 9.
This is what we tell the difference, though. This is definitely what we tell the difference. Right here. Now, this is a new formation I'm throwing right now, so I don't know how this shit finna work, but be patient with me. Hold on. Let me see. There's some new shit I'm trying. Hold on. There we go. Oh, okay. I gotta move. Put speed on this. I gotta move. I gotta put more speed right there. Good D, but the dude, the person I had checking the running back was slow as fuck.
Here's Herbert.
That's why. Oh, come on, you gotta pick that off, man. He jumped up and smacked it, but you gotta pick that. Hold on, so who this is? Give me. Yeah, we'll keep it like that.
Here's second and 10.
Oh, we know what it's going. We know what it's going. We know what it's going. Watch number 13. Watch number 13. Watch number 13. Didn't I just tell you? The man letting him. Yeah, before the play even started, I knew where that was going. His shit's so predictable. Justin Herbert. You could tell from the way he lined up where he was going.
Touchdown against them with one of their own. Extra point up and good by Dicker, and we are tied at 7.
See, you don't care if I go to the school. It's funny you can play with a nigga and try shit in the middle of a game. You'll see. Stay there. I'm there.
The return man down to a knee, and this will come out to the 25-yard line.
Alright, so this is something I wanted to try too. So
the Rams offense ready for their drive here against their LA brethren. A lot of time for this unit to game plan on the sideline after that drive that they watched the other side just score. But remember, last time they were out, they scored as well. So we'll see if they can seize that momentum right back.
And they have had a lot of time to cool.
Keep running. Thank you. He just didn't catch the ball.
I like that.
That's one of the ones I can play with. That's definitely one of the ones. I learned some on this one too yesterday.
If you get your hands on it, you should expect to make the play. That could have gone for big yardage, but you just couldn't get it to stick to those big mitts.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25.
Alright, so I learned on this one. Oh, they're not letting me do it since the play is already in motion. Stay up.
He'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds. He'll get only 3 there, so it leaves him with a 3rd and 7 ahead.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense because the defense brought pressure that time. And sometimes against that, you can get out to your running back, and it can turn into a big gain downfield.
but what a nice job they did getting to him quickly and holding him to a short gain.
These two teams all tied after one. The Rams with the football here to begin the second quarter as they've got it with a third down coming up. So 7 yards from the first down here as they come up to the line of scrimmage. Throwing on third down, Stafford. Pass to the sideline and pulled in. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. That's a third down conversion to 24 yards there. Nice play. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times because he can trust you being in the right spot, and they connected there and picked up a first down.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
The coverage keyed in on him since that last completion his way. He earned a little more attention on that route, and that made it a lot tougher to get a clean throw his way.
Double right. Now a second and 10.
40 gut.
Now Stafford. And he's corralled at the 40, but not before picking up 8.
Fired that one in there, able to make connection on a nice in route.
With those faster passes when they're going that fast, any hesitation as a quarterback that the deflection, if you miss, might be bigger and lead to an interception?
Yeah, and the deflection works both ways. Maybe a defender gets a hand in the way and it pops in the air. And sometimes you throw it so hard your receiver can't handle it, and he pops it up in the air for the defenders to grab as well.
But a moot point there as they were able to connect. They give it to Freeman up the gun. And he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37.
Alert!
Freeman again. And he'll fight forward on the straight ahead running for just a couple of yards. Second down.
Well,
Stafford going to change it up here. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Open man is Atwell, complete. And he's brought to the ground with another first down at the Chargers 18. They give him 17 yards that time as that'll move the chains.
Well, this is an awfully tough route to defend in man coverage because he lines up on the right and then runs a crossing route back to the other side of the field. So as a defender, you're not only trailing him the whole way, you're also looking out for your own guys to make sure you don't get yourself picked off, and then you can't catch up in time to prevent the completion.
Now a first down throw, Stafford. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
They're putting together a drive here in the final minutes of the half, but the coverage has been tight all game long, and they certainly want to keep them off the scoreboard here.
Second and 10.
Monday.
Throwing is Stafford. He'll find a man over the middle, 2-2 Atwell. The Chargers going to signal for the first of their timeouts. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. So they need 2 yards here on third down. Remember, they're already 2-2 on third down conversions on this drive. They'll try and run for it. Here's Williams. He's going to be a yard short. Needed 2, but only got 1. Fourth down.
Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys. Made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
Hey, 70!
They snap it to Stafford. And he's brought down. Can't do anything with a football. It's a sack and a turnover on downs. The Charger offense set to take over in this battle for L.A.
Well, certainly they'd rather have the scenario they had last time out, Charles. Remember, they had the short field. They took it in the end zone. Now this is going to have to be a longer, more sustained drive if they want to get points.
Yeah, a little bit more of a quick strike opportunity last time by where they were on the field, and you're exactly right about that. But now, backed up a little bit, what's that old expression we love to use? Time to matriculate the ball down the field and try and do it again.
And he is out of bounds, able to get it across the 20-yard line. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be third and less than a yard. So from second and long, now we go to third and very manageable.
Yeah, they love that phrase, don't they? Because as an offensive coordinator, you can keep people a little bit off balance and guessing because you don't have to throw it. You can come back with a strong run game if you want to. And if you're in four down territory, that really opens things up for you.
Wiggles free,
and that's going to be good for a Chargers first down as he's able to take this up to the 30-yard line.
Now the Chargers hustling, trying to get up and get set.
Not liking the look, they'll change the play.
Running on first down, Eckler. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
Now Herbert with it, looking to pass.
That's into the hands of Eckler.
Now the Chargers will use the second of their timeouts, as he'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. On first down, Justin Herbert. It's complete to Williams. And they'll get this to the 30-yard line before crossing over out of bounds. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. And it's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
And he'll be out of bounds just inside the 25-yard line. And that's good for a gain of 6, and it'll be second down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
Again, Herbert.
And this is incomplete. Oh, that looked like a sure 6 points, but he could not get that to stick, and that is a golden opportunity wasted there.
And that is not what you expect from a receiver of his caliber. Sometimes you get a little ahead of yourself, you don't look it in, and all of a sudden it's on the ground. A surprise to all.
This will be play number 9 of the drive here as they need 4 yards on third down. Here's Herbert.
Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete.
Chargers going to use their third and final timeout as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half.
So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10.
Herbert operating from the red zone. Under pressure, and he'll go down back at the 26-yard line. Now the Rams will signal for a timeout, their second, as it'll come with 36 ticks to go in half number one. Sacks a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long.
Let's go, let's go.
Now it's Herbert.
That is caught. It's Williams. And out of bounds all the way down at the 3. 23 yards, the final tally. Eckler will struggle to get to the line of scrimmage as he'll be tackled back at the 4-yard line. From back at the 4, here's second and goal. From the shotgun, here's Herbert. He finds his receiver, Williams, for a Charger touchdown. Mike Williams in the final seconds of the first half. And the Chargers have taken the lead here in the final stages of this first half. Extra point up and good by Dicker. And that makes the score 14-7. So not much time to work with here. 9 seconds remain in the half as this one is away. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. The Rams offense ready for their drive here against their L.A. brethren. And with 5 seconds to go, this will likely be our final play. A final shot before the break. Stafford got a man. It's Higbee complete. And with just 1 second remaining in the first half, they'll call the timeout. So with 1 second left in the half, on is the field goal unit. And this will be called officially a 66-yard attempt. And that one's not going to get there. Not enough juice and ambitious effort, but it's well short. So 2 quarters down, 2 remain. Charles and I return after the break. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number 3 alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon.
A 1-touchdown ball game, 14-7 our scores. We get back at it on EA Sports. The fair catch taken short of the goal line, and they'll begin this third quarter at their own 25. Herbert and the Chargers now with a 1st and 10
at their own 25-yard line. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
I see the surprise in your face there, partner. That is a rare incompletion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion-wise way up, not that time. An incomplete pass leads to 2nd and 10 from the 25. Ready. Herbert. Man open left side, it's Williams. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. He continues to deliver a 1st down here. He had 4 catches in the first half, and this one number 5. And they'll bring the big tight end across the formation left.
And they'll let the quarterback keep it here on 1st and 10. And he goes out of bounds. It looks like right at the 50. 9 yards on the first down. Keeper in at second and one.
Now that's what he can do, you know, when he keeps the football. It's not a huge gain, but it shows how hard it can be to stop him.
Yeah, and I thought the defense had that one pretty well contained. And, in fact, they probably came up and felt pretty good about what they did. Then they looked up and realized he still got good yardage out of it. He's a tough guy to stop.
The 20. Five. Touchdown. Keenan Allen. His second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Chargers come right out of the locker room and score here in the opening minute of the third quarter.
In order to lead in a game, you're going to get plenty of contributors, but that's his second touchdown catch of this game. He's one of the key guys in this one.
And you better believe he'll be looking for the hat trick here as this one continues to go. Extra point up and good by Dicker. And it's now 21-7.
Here's Dicker now as he'll send this one away. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24.
The Rams offense ready for their drive here against their L.A. brethren.
And their deficit a little wider than it was at halftime. Does that touchdown a minute ago change the thinking here at all?
I think it does, at least a little bit, because now urgency has to start setting in. You can't go out there and go three and out and run the risk of falling behind substantially, but you have to do it without pressing, because pressing, that'll lead you into bigger errors.
They'll fake the give. Now Stafford.
He'll drop this down to Williams.
That'll go for a gain of 7, and it's second down.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice, safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
From the 31, here's second and 3.
Now a play fake it at Stafford. He's got a man complete. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. A very nice pickup of 33 yards. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. Stafford now to throw. Oh, hit as he throws there, incomplete.
Partner, what we're seeing so far is a defense that's certainly coordinated. Both levels doing their jobs in tandem. The back helping the front helping the back. The pressure got home on that last play and forced him to try and throw through contact and short of the sticks.
Now a deep ball there on second down, but it'll wind up incomplete.
Well, when the running game's not working, sometimes you just got to take a few more chances down the field. That's a good effort, but it winds up incomplete.
This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at 3rd and 10. Off of play action. Here's Stafford. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Well, how about the coverage we just saw him break out on 3rd down? Dime defense, blanketed the field with extra defensive backs and speed, unable to find an open hole to complete that pass.
The kick by Maher is good, and that will get the disadvantage now back down to 11.
So the response to that touchdown on the other side to begin the third quarter. Look, just 3 points, but still a response nonetheless.
You're exactly right about that, because I think you needed to answer back with something, even though it's not 6. Just enough to send the message that says, hey, we're not going away.
After the made field goal, Maher back out there to kick it away.
But no run back here. Fair catch, and this will come out to the 25. The Charger offense set to take over in this battle for L.A. Right now, everything they touch turns to gold. This is their fourth possession. Touchdowns on their first three possessions. I mean, this defense, they can't seem to stop them. It's like they're on skates.
Great analogy, Brandon, because they are pushing them back and winning everything at the line of scrimmage. They've just been laying down tracks towards the opposite end zone. So to themselves, all they're saying is, if we don't make a mistake, there's no way they can stop us.
They'll break the huddle, come up on second and eight at the 27-yard line. Once more, here's Eckler. And he'll take this up to the 30, a gain of four. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
From the gun, Herbert on third down. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. A big play that time on the catch and run. And the Chargers are going to get themselves a fresh set of downs here. Herbert will give this one to Eckler. And they'll get him down after a pickup of eight, second and two.
Hitting had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. And they run the option on second down. And holding it may be the wrong decision as he stopped in the backfield. Chalk that up as a four-yard loss, and now it's third down. And as they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. If they want a first, they need to get the football to the 32 here on third down. Here's Herbert. That is caught. And some room to maneuver. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. Now a first and 10 at the 11. Now Herbert going to shift his guys around. Up the middle with Eckler. Powers through him. And he'll take this one inside the 10, down to the 8. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
And he's going to press this one forward as they stop him right around the 1. A gain of 3 last play. This time they double it and pick up 6.
Some good strong running right there. Some power and some explosiveness just about got them into the end zone.
They'll look to make it 3 for 3 on third down conversions. They need a yard here.
And they'll try and run the option to pick it up.
And he will get in across the chalk for a Chargers touchdown. Justin Herbert keeping it himself from a yard out. And the Chargers have pretty well put it away here in the fourth quarter.
Is it okay if I break one of our rules, partner, which is to never call a game over until it's over? Because this certainly feels like it's over after that drive.
Yeah, that was spirit-crushing, wasn't it? And now you just kind of felt the air go out of the balloon.
Yeah, they were fighting so hard to stay in there, and they knew they had to stop them on that drive. But when they were unable to, I think you're exactly right. You could see them sag on their sideline, and I think this one might just be over.
Extra point up and good by Dicker, and the lead is up to 18 now.
Hold on, listen. He been quiet the whole fucking game. Now he talking. Hold on. Remember when I said that? Hold on, listen.
Will bounce out of the back.
back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. I'm going to let him talk, then I'm going to mute his audio again. I'm going to let him keep talking, then I'm going to mute his audio. Hold on, here you go. I'm not rude. Hold on.
The Rams offense ready for their drive here against their L.A. brethren. Last time out, you remember their drive stalled, but thanks to their kicker, booted a long field goal to at least get them three. Now here they'll try to do better and find the end zone. And
in our experience, tell. You think you're done? You think you're done talking? Okay, I'll leave the mic on a little bit longer. Hold on. I'm just checking. Hold on. Let me check and see if he's done. Hold on. He might have some more to say. Hold on. He might have more to say. He would be content to just kick extra points. He moaning and giggling on here too. Listen, just listen.
I think his teammates would be okay with him just kicking the extra points as well.
So, do you think he done? You think he done talking, or you think he's still talking? You think he done? So this is what I think he think. He think he good enough to stop me if I'm live. I think he. Oh, he won't go back and forth now that he got this. I'm going to mute the audio just because he's still. He team.
In this case, down a couple of scores. Want to make sure they have a chance to win this ball game.
That's what you call a fourth quarter gangster. They get on the mic in the fourth fucking quarter when they feel like the game is done, and that's when they start talking. Niggas don't do that. You could have talked the whole fucking game. This was boring. This was a boring ass game. I wanted to actually play somebody who's gonna talk. That's what I look for. Niggas who get on the mic. This was just a free fucking game. He got on his bitch and cut the mic off. Like, I ain't had no reason to turn up because my opponent pussy. I don't have no reason to get gangsta or talk or have to play hard because my opponent ain't say nothing. This nigga cut the mic off in the first quarter, and then cut it back on in the fourth. People like him are forever pussy. I promise y'all have to win this game. I promise y'all don't. 20 years later, I promise you one loss ain't gonna make a difference. But if y'all see Big Time Dub in the motherfucking chat, he a bitch and he not gonna play. He not gonna cut the mic on. Regardless of what you say to him. Then he cut the mic on in the fourth as if he accomplished some shit. You beat the Rams. Whoop the fucking do.
Stafford on first down. Forced out to his left.
Promise you I'm not worried. Yeah. Promise you I'm not worried. Promise you I'm not worried. This game. I don't know reason to go hard, nigga. We watching Randall and bullshitting. I'm not, dude. I don't know reason to turn up against you.
And he brings this one back. It's a pick six and a Charger TD. This has just really been a solid second half from them, CD, as they add another touchdown to the lead and they start to pull away in what was once a close ball game.
Yeah, they actually put the Jets on in this one, didn't they? Put a little cherry on top with that touchdown. Now we just got to play out this final minute and they'll get a chance to celebrate a very hard-earned victory.
Extra point up and good by Dicker. And they open the lead up now to 25.
Exactly. He, and mind you, he quit three fucking times. We were supposed to play three times. That nigga had the fucking Ravens and ducked me three fucking times. I even got the Houston Texans. I was never interested in playing this nigga with a regular team. I went and got a sad team twice. But he on the mic talking like he really just beat a nigga. Shut your dumb ass up. If you would have been on the mic like you was in the fourth, like you was in the first, I'd have kicked your fucking face in. I'd have kicked your face in just to shut your ass up. And if you're a grown man who can't take another grown man talking shit, then you a bitch. Shouldn't even be on the game, honestly. Talking that rah-rah, who we supposed to be on this bitch asking each other phone numbers, being friends, being aight? Nigga, you are a pony. Fuck, I look like being cool with you, or wanting to be cool with you, or caring about being cool with you. Nigga, my job is to demolish you.
Oh, he tries to force it in, and
it's what you got to do. Thank you.
That he brings this one back.
I'm going to show you how important this fucking game is. I'm going to show you.
And now
it's just kind of becoming a feast on the defensive side of the football.
And that's the thing. That's what, and I said that shit at the beginning of the stream. I said, why I can't never meet niggas like this when I'm playing with a good team? Why can't I? Why can't I?
But these guys going to be freewheeling now. All of them are going to take chances.
But the dog in me be wanting to see, you know what I'm saying, what I'm capable of with sad teams against good teams. I be wanting to see. I swear I do.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Rams offense.
Trust, man, when I tell you I'm not worried about this.
Their L.A. brethren. They are just obviously getting shellacked here in this one, Charles. What's the
I'm at 270. I'm trying to get the win 300. I'm definitely not worried. Go get it. I done threw you two pick sixes. Now get you a free touchdown. Thank you. I'm going to show you just how important this shit not. This is a free fucking game. Now throw some bread up. Throw some bread up. And you can pick my team. Throw some bread up. Throw some bread up. I'm going to show you how I feel to get 80 points and still not be fucking phased.
And you can bet they're preaching two hands on the ball here as the kicks away following that fumble.
Probably going to see you using them again, bitch. I'm going to make you quit. I promise you, you're not good enough to make me quit, but I promise you I'm going to make you quit. Don't touch the ball. Oh, yeah. There it is. Computer's going to touch it. Computer's going to touch it. Thank you, safety. Thank you. Nah, he don't want to touch the ball. I'm kicking out of bounds then. I know how to get out of a game. You got me fucked up. You got me fucked up. Man, don't talk to me. Shut your bitch ass up. I know how to get out of a game. You finna see. I'm finna show you. No stats for you. No stats for you.
Right at the 50-yard line.
Oh, Steve, get on my stats. You should have talked from the first through the fourth. Now you want to talk in the fourth. Shut your dumb ass up. Shut your dumb ass up. Ain't no real nigga ain't going to let no another nigga make them. Why are you pausing the game? You are.
A boost here to start the drive.
Hold on, he's still talking. That whole time he was muting, he still was talking. That whole time he was talking.
And a flag, and I think we got a jump here. A bit of a jump there, CD. He breaks the line. And
hold on, listen to the gas giggling, though. Look, listen how he laughs. Listen. Listen.
Just a free gift to the offense.
After the penalty, a fresh set of downs. It's first and 10.
But see, that's the thing. He just talking. I told you, if this person would have been here in the first, we would have had a good time. Yes, sir. Man, I'm not listening to this. Somebody take my penalty. Hold on, he's still talking. I don't want to hear him. Hey, I'm about to mute you in 3, 2.
From the 39-yard line. It's Eckler again. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race down the left sideline.
Selling out of here to doing stadiums. Gold diggers don't come around, they dancing by my radius. I keep it too real for real, and that's what made me rich. That's what made me. friends with the ops. And that you need better stocks. Standing on my money, dog. Please don't get the involved. Ain't nobody running off. Rules to the basics. I can't be no son-in-law. I can't take the summer off. I make it look good and all, but this is no vacation. Only fools, they respect me and I know. Watch your words and your tone, you're not a poet. My advice, please don't try to be heroic. Let me know they
whole club selling out of here to doing stadiums. Gold diggers don't come around, they don't survive my radius. I keep it too real for real, and that's what made me rich. That's what made me rich. Hustling, that's what made me rich.
Yeah, whole club selling out of here to doing stadiums. Small business don't come around, they don't survive my radius. All I talk about, and that's what really made me rich. Hustling, that's what made me rich. That's what made me rich.
I never had a mentor. Office. I met her at a club. She twerked better when her heart break. Hey, hood, the one I wanna, everything that I got. I'm praying for a Bentley and to never go to jail. I'm fresh up out the gutter, I don't know if you can tell. I'm hustling for everything I do for legacy. You can call me any type of day, my dog, I never sleep. The only rule I got is if we don't embarrass me. I write down my problems, then record it just for therapy, just for clarity.
Old club selling out of here to doing stadiums. Gold diggers don't come around, they don't survive my radius. I keep it too real for real, and that's what made me rich. That's what made me rich. Hustling, that's what made me rich.
Yeah, old club selling out of here to doing stadiums. Small business don't come around, they don't survive my radius. All I talk about, and that's what really made me rich. Hustling, that's what made me rich. That's what made me rich. The whole club.
Say you gon' ride, say you gon' step by me. Spin the slide, say you gon' step by me. Who gon' step by me? Who gon' step by me?
Yeah, told him I would be a boss. It's the NFL on EA Sports, and we are a mile high at Broncos Stadium in Denver, Colorado.
Straight ahead, we've got a pretty good one on tap here, as it'll be the Arizona Cardinals taking on the Denver Broncos. And off we go from Denver. And they will elect to not bring this one out, as our first drive will begin at the 25.
They'll bring one of the tight ends in motion left. They begin the drive with Williams. He'll be dropped after a gain of about six across the...
Say, what we doing? We talking or what? That's a really... I see you got that mic. Mic up. What up?
Blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning into...
What is it? Run. And a lot of times, you blitz a running play, you're going to smother... We talking or what? What down?
Blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
Thank you.
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete.
It's another zone defense. It looks like it's open for possibilities, but they did a nice job patrolling the middle of the field and forcing an incompletion.
And they'll look to avoid an early three and out here on third and four.
Hey, alert.
Now it's Wilson. He's got his target. That's complete. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. From midfield now, here's Wilson. Open man, and again it's Sutton. And this will leave him a yard short.
Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down.
Good job right there. Good job right there.
On second down, Wilson. And he's going to have the hook up to Sutton. And Sutton will have a Broncos first down as he'll get this down inside the 35. Now it's Wilson. And his throw is incomplete.
Well, a momentary speed bump there with that throw, partner. The defense had other ideas, and they're trying to mount a small stand before this drive reaches the end zone.
From the 34, they'll come to the line on second and 10. Again, Wilson. Got a man open. It's Sutton. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 and mark him at the 5. A big play there on the catch and run. And the Broncos are going to have a new set of downs. Here we go now on first and goal. They'll try and run. This is Williams. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. Now from the 7, here's second and goal. Williams will try again. And he is into the end zone for a Denver touchdown. Javonte Williams taking it in from 7 yards away. And the Broncos get the upper hand as they're on the board first here this afternoon. Lutz with the extra point, and that makes the score 7-0. After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. Now Greg Dortch going to bring it out of the end zone. And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. Murray and the Cardinals with a first and 10 at their own 26. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. He's got this downfield to McBride. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. 23 yards on the play. So one play, and they're already just shy of midfield. Murray now. And incomplete on the deep ball. Not sure what happened out there, but it looked like the timing was a little off on that throw.
Well, you know I'm a defender, so what am I going to say?
Great defense.
And darn right. They did something to disrupt that timing.
Hey, Larry. Easy.
Murray looks to throw again, second and 10. And this is caught. It's Brown. And this is going to be another first down as they'll make the tackle at the Broncos 30. A gain there of 21 yards. So a first and 10 now in Denver territory at the 30-yard line. Here's Murray. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
So it looks like they still have some fight in them on this series because it seemed like things were headed for the red zone. But if this defense gets two more stops, they can keep them out of that area.
They'll fake it to Connor. Now Murray. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
They've given him some different looks here defensively in the early going. He's only hit 2 of his first 5 passes. With a big third down coming up, he's hoping he's got a play dialed up that can take advantage of whatever the defense throws at him.
Murray to air it out again. And that is caught. Touchdown, Cardinals. Trey McBride, 30 yards. And the Cardinals respond to that opening drive touchdown with one of their own. Extra point good by Prater. And we are tied at 7. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. And he had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20. Denver offense at the line, ready to go. A long drive last time out for this offense, Charles. If you remember, they started basically in the shadows of their own end zone, marched it down the field, and a lot of that was through the passing game.
And partner, as a former defensive back, I'm having almost a physical reaction watching what's happening right now, but let's give credit where it's due because they've done an excellent job moving the ball through the air. Secondary getting picked apart pass by pass. Obviously, they need to make some adjustments there on the back end.
Yeah, because offensively, we know that they're not going to be shy about throwing that football. And he's going to have a Broncos first down as the tackle made just shy of the 40.
14.
Again, it's Williams. And he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up.
Punch left. 14. Start.
Now they'll throw it with Wilson. Oh, hit as he throws there. Incomplete.
You've always been very good about checking my math. Am I correct? That's the first time that it's been incomplete when they've thrown it to him?
Yes, he had caught every other ball coming his way.
So they feel like they've got something really good going there, and they're going to continue to go there until the defense makes an adjustment and takes it away.
Well, they finally made an adjustment there. We'll see if they can build on that stop. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made here at the Cardinals' 38-yard line. 7-7, our score after one. So into Cardinal territory now. It's first and 10 at the 38. Here's Wilson. He'll drop this down to Williams. And he'll get this one down to about the 20-yard line. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there. And they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
From the red zone now, here's Wilson on first down. He completes this to Sutton. Touchdown, Broncos! Russ able to connect with Cortland Sutton there, and the Broncos have taken the lead. Lutzel looked to add the extra point. And he's got it. It's now a 14-7 ball game. After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. After that last score we just saw, now 14-7, so a chance to march down the field here, try to tie this football game. Meanwhile, they take a shot to start the drive, but this is going to wind up incomplete.
Boy, that ball's just hanging up there, waiting to be intercepted. That looked doomed from the start, but they took the deep shot anyway, and fortunately, it winds up incomplete.
Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well.
So many offenses want to include their running backs into their passing offense and be able to swing the ball out or check it down to them. But sometimes those guys are just not as comfortable catching the ball as they are running it.
Play action. Now it's Murray. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football.
Oh, and one of the
Johnson, oh, it's poked free. Football's out.
But it looks like one of the DBs has it.
And that will set him up in excellent shape. First and goal at the 9-yard line. The defense gets him the ball via the turnover. Now can this offense cash in? First and goal. The slot man in motion right.
They'll fake the jet sweep and instead of give up the middle to Williams.
And he's going to pull his way down to about the 1-yard line.
44 yards rushing for him now in the ballgame.
Two of their three red zone trips so far they've come up empty on. They'll look to reverse that trend on second and goal. And he is not going to get in as the big bodies stop him at the one.
Now they'd really like to make the short field pay off. We'll see if they can, but this is third and goal.
Now the Broncos are going to call the first of their timeouts. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter.
Big play coming here. It's third and goal.
14, Friday.
Williams. The defense stiffens to force fourth down following that first down gain of 8. Well, if this defense can hold them to a field goal here, what a win that would be.
Not just a win on the possession, but psychologically take over the ball game. But this started with first and goal, so they were in four down territory right from the beginning. I say you finish it off and go for the touchdown.
Now on fourth down here, that pass knocked away and incomplete.
Fourth down and they take to the air, which really isn't a major surprise, but how about the coverage there, able to bat it down.
Arizona's offense at the line, ready to get their drive started. And a fumble last time, ball security. Talk about it all the time in the National Football League. They've got to be better at it on this drive.
Don't you think that when every team gets together for the first time, I don't care if it's OTAs, mini camps, first day of camp in the regular season, ball security comes up about what, the second sentence of the coach's address?
And those are so many drills focus on that.
All the time, and they do drills to make it even tougher to simulate game situations. Doesn't always work out, though.
And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. Another first down, this time on a gain of 19. We've hit the two-minute mark of the second quarter, 14-7.
We can talk all we want about football being a game of strength and brawn. It's also a game of mismatches, and they're trying to create one there, getting it to their back out of the backfield to make a bigger play.
As we often say, get it to him in space, let him use his leg.
Yeah, if he can get a matchup against a linebacker or maybe a defensive end dropping out in a zone blitz, he's going to win that battle just about every time.
Line of scrimmage, again the 37 as they line up second and 10. Throwing again, Murray. Screen pass to Connor. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. That one good for 26 and a first down.
And when you're throwing the ball downfield really well like they have been on this drive, it's really a nice time to work one of the screen plays in. One of my favorite play callers in the game has always told me he starts every game with 10 to 12 screens.
And Murray in trouble here, and down he goes. More than one defender there, and that's a loss of 5 on the sack. Got to assume this defense will be charging again here. It's second and 15. Now Murray. And he'll be hit as he releases it. And that'll fall incomplete. The pressure really ratcheting up. They get the sack on first down, then a near sack. They got to him there just as it was leaving his hand.
Yeah, they might need to change their pass protection scheme a little bit. Maybe bring another guy into the backfield to help protect the quarterback, because that was awfully close.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And that's going to be incomplete. The coverage too good there. The contact popped the ball free, and it's fourth down. So coming on now is the field goal unit. They're going to try for 3, and he'll need all the leg he's got here. Prater's kick is good, and they'll cut the lead back down to 4 now at 14-10.
So they're able to end that drive with 3 points in this one possession ball game.
And ideally, you want to end every drive with points. Most quarterbacks would tell you, let's end it with a kick, right? A PAT, that's number one. Field goal, you'll take. Punts, you really don't want to do that. In this case, they'll take the field goal and get prepared for the rest of the game.
The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive.
And not an abundance of time remains on the clock, Charles, but you would think more than enough to try to extend this lead before intermission.
And when you're talking about extending the lead, I think you're talking about aiming for the end zone, because there is plenty of time for that. The fallback is to get 3. But in your mind, you put 6 on the board right before the half. That's a heck of a dagger and great momentum to carry into the locker room.
Wilson's throw caught here by Dulcich. Now the Broncos going to use the second of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in half number 1. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Wilson. That would almost intercepted, but it's incomplete. Not a good throw there, and it'll be second down.
Well, they've been back on their heels a little bit here in this drive. But a chance to exhale just a little bit there with incompletion on first down. Now they have to gear up, try and get 2 more stops, and escape this drive.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Here's Wilson to throw.
He finds Sutton crossing the formation complete.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. To throw again is Wilson. He finds his man complete. That's Sutton. That'll leave him with a third and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there.
And we've seen him have success earlier on with the ball in his hands because he is a get it in space and make a play kind of a receiver. But that time, they closed on him quickly and held him to a short gain.
It's a 47-yard field goal try from here, but instead they're going to opt to go for it on fourth down. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Jalen Thompson picks it, and the Cards are going to get the ball back on the turnover as they hold on fourth down. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And they'll have time for one play. That's it. 3 seconds to go before intermission. Meanwhile, Murray's throw complete to McBride. And way up past the 35 before he's taken down. First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. It'll be the Cardinals who get the ball first. They trail here as we resume action in the third quarter. And Greg Dortch now to return it. And some good special teams coverage as they bring him down just outside of the 15. Murray and the Cardinals with a first and 10 at their own 16. Second half starts with a run by Carter. They'll get him to the ground at the 20 following a pickup of 4. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. First carry for James Conner. He finds some open field here. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. On first and 10, it's Carter. And he's got Rome. Still on his feet. And down to the 29-yard line. That one good for 37 yards. So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. And now Murray's going to set up the throw. And he's got the hook up to Moore. And he's brought down, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line. A good pickup there, 21 yards. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit them, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. They fake the handoff. Now Murray. A throw to the flat for Carter. Touchdown, Cardinals! Michael Carter from 8 yards out. And the Cardinals have taken the lead as they go right down the field and score on the opening drive of the second half. Prater for the extra point, and it's now 17-14. And after the touchdown, out is Prater to kick. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. Denver offense at the line, ready to go. And Charles, it feels like we're set up for a good second half here. Came out of the locker room, one score game. Now the lead has already changed hands. And now off to the races, down the right side.
And he's going to be ridden out of bounds, down inside the 25.
A huge play there for Denver, 62 yards. So barely time to catch our breath. Here's first and 10 just outside the red zone. Now it's Wilson. Steps away. And that'll be incomplete.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable, and that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they brought the heat, and if he flushes out, they're fine with that.
Touchdown! Jerry Jeudy, a 22-yard touchdown grab. And the Broncos have retaken a third-quarter lead. Lutz good on the extra point, and that will make this a four-point game. After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. They'll elect to bring it out here from the end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. Arizona's offense at the line, ready to get their drive started. They had seized the lead there for a little bit with a starting drive in the third quarter, but a moment ago, the touchdown that puts them back behind.
So their defense is under siege a little bit right now because they have not able to solve their opponents. So they've got to keep hammering away on offense and try and win this one in what appears to be a shootout.
That's caught inside the 20. And he's brought down after a very nice gain. So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. Here's Murray as he sets to throw it. Throwing the out route and complete. It's Connor. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. They're going to hurry back to the line now.
Big ace. Hey.
Murray now to throw. Flushed out right. And it looks like he'll be just a yard shy of the five here as he's out at the six. 6 yards there off the scramble, but it'll still leave him with a third down. So they just need 1 yard here to pick up the first down. They'll run with Carter. And he won't have the touchdown, but he will have the first down as he's tackled at the two. Connor is not going to get back to the line of scrimmage as they'll tackle him at the three. So they're backed up to the 3 yard line, second and goal. On play action, it's Murray. And he'll take this one in for the Arizona touchdown. Kyler Murray, a 3 yard touchdown run. And the Cardinals have taken the lead here in the final seconds of the third quarter. Extra point good by Prater, and that gives him a 3-point lead. And after the touchdown, out is Prater to kick. And we'll see a return here from the end zone. And he'll be out of bounds here just past the 20-yard line. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated groups. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out, looking to repeat that in Charles's defense. They were very frustrated after giving up six the last time on the field.
And frankly, it's just a battle of wills in a lot of ways because you know they're both motivated. They both game plan for this drive, and they both have...
They couldn't ask for much more to this point in the second half. A gorgeous day, one score game, first and 10 here. Now Wilson. Finding Williams once more, complete. And he's able to get this to the 40-yard line before he's out of bounds. Another first down there as this one goes for 25. Now it's Wilson on the move to his left. Screen play set up for Williams. And this one's going to go the wrong way, losing yardage back at the 42. That one unable to develop, never got going. A loss of a couple, and it's second down.
Spot that.
Throwing is Wilson out to his left. And this one too low.
And next time, Brandon, I think you might want to consider running it because those defensive backs, they were plastered to the receivers and they weren't letting up as that play went on.
So they'll try to move the ball closer here on third down. A field goal from this spot would be just inside of 60 yards, 59 to be exact.
36 power.
Cut. They'll run out of the gun here. Williams. Oh, he bowls over him. And a good job defensively. They stop him short of the first at the 32. One score down. Here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. In motion goes Patrick. And that is caught. Touchdown, Denver. Making a hat trick for Russell Wilson. Three touchdown passes now. And the Broncos answer back with a touchdown of their own to take a fourth quarter lead. Lutz with the extra point. And that will make this a four-point game. After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. This fielded right at the goal line. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. Ready to go with their next drive and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And they will be looking to answer the touchdown. Their defense just surrendered. Still a good chunk of time remaining here in the fourth quarter and a chance to regain the lead in a tight one. Oh, he had a man open. He overshot him. It's incomplete. Now Murray throwing on second down. And this will be swung out here for Connor. They do get a yard there, but only a yard. Leaves them with third and nine looming.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really...
And Murray in trouble here, and down he goes. The defense rising to the challenge and setting him back on the sack. Here comes the Cardinals punter now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. He'll send this one into the mile high air, and it's a good one. A big boot that time. 57 yards the official distance. And the Broncos take over. First down and 10. Denver offense at the line, ready to go. Their defense got the stop, forced the punt, and now you really start to monitor the clock as they nurse this slim lead. A little jet sweep to start the drive. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
An excellent run there coming from out wide.
And we used to consider these jet sweeps to be gadget plays or something a little bit unusual, right? But now most teams have some version of this play in their playbook. And I think it's a lot because of the receivers that are being developed nowadays. These guys look like running backs, even though they're playing out on the perimeter.
Five points of contact necessary at this stage as they'll run on first down. And good vision there as he's across midfield and down to the 45-yard line.
I have to chuckle to myself a little bit, Brandon, because right now, I could be in that huddle with that offensive line, and I know exactly what they're saying. If you call a pass play here, we're going to call a timeout. Run the football. We've got control of this thing. Get in behind us and let's go.
Their time to shine. Oh, he'll air this one deep for Judy. And this is caught inside the five. Touchdown, Broncos. Jerry Judy. Two catches, two touchdowns here so far. And the Broncos are able to build on to their fourth quarter lead.
What a huge touchdown that was, obviously, here in the late stages of the fourth quarter as they try to put this one away.
And Brandon, when they watch the film after this week, they'll be very proud of every rep if they close this game out. Just a few snaps remaining, they can't relax just yet.
Lutz good on the extra point, and that pushes the lead up to 11. After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off.
And here comes a return from a few steps into the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback.
This is first and 10.
2-2.
They'll fake it to Connor. Now Murray. Gets this to Moore. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. The Cardinals going to use the first of their timeouts as it comes with a minute 15 left to go in the second half. On first and 10, here's Murray. He's going to let it fly. This is caught inside the 15. Touchdown, Cardinals. Rondale Moore, 55 yards. And the Cardinals have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth.
No, we're not cheering. No, we're not rooting. But I am excited about this, and I know you are too. We got a ball game again after that big-time strike.
Big-time strike, and you are right. Don't go anywhere yet. This thing's not done. So certainly some importance to this one now. After the touchdown, they could get this down to a field goal with a two-point conversion. Now Murray. Oh, and that's going to sabotage their comeback plans. It is intercepted. Picked off by Fabian Moreau. And he takes it all the way back. It's a pick two, if you will, as that play backfires in a big way. And after the touchdown, out is Prater to kick. And they will not get a chance to return this one. It's through the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And checking the timeouts, they do have two defensively, but no real need to use them as they're not going to be able to stop the clock after that. Had a bit of a lane there, took advantage of it. Give them seven there on the first down carry. Now the Cards going to call another timeout, their second, as it comes with a minute 4 left to go in the game. So they come up on second down. If they can get another run like we just saw, it would likely put an end to this thing. Here's Wilson. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Well, you most certainly don't want to go three and out here and give the football right back because your friend, Old Momentum, he's wondering if he should change sidelines about right now. And if you don't convert here, guess what? He's going to make the trek to the opposite side, and all of a sudden, you've got a battle on your hands.
And he is going to have the Broncos first, and that should be the capper. It's a gain of 4, and that should just about seal the deal.
Well, someone's been having a good game so far, and you know something? A lot of it's been power running. They decided to turn him loose again on third down, didn't they?
They did indeed. He delivered the tough yards. What? So from the 36 now, first and 10. They run it again with Williams. And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple and that's it. Charles, why didn't they just take the knee there?
You're asking the question that I'm asking as well, because we've seen a lot of football where coaches decide maybe they get a little greedy. I don't know if they're doing it for stats or for what reason. We've seen it happen in college. And how about in the NFL? The miracle at the Meadowlands. All they had to do was take a knee and the game was over. The Giants ran it one more time. Ball popped free. Philadelphia picks it up and wins the game.
What year was that?
1978. I think it was in November.
Throwing now is Wilson. Able to find the open man. That's complete. Oh, some strong running. And he's across for the touchdown. And in the final minute, that should just about seal it.
And that touchdown, Charles, with very little time remaining, boy, it just sucked any energy and momentum out of the other sideline.
Yeah, take an incredible comeback in the final minute to bring this one back to even. A great series there offensively. They saw an opportunity to slam the window shut, and they followed through.
And he is into the end zone to bump the lead up two more. After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. He will return this from deep in the end zone. And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20.
Let's go.
And they'll indeed take a knee. And they take a knee. Well, this was a fun one today if you like points. A lot of them went on the board. Both offenses were clicking. Charles's defenses, meanwhile, have a little something to clean up before their next contest.
Yeah, neither end zone had a stop sign in it, did they? I mean, for both sides, visit it, and with frequency. Not fun to be a defensive player, but on the offensive side of the ball, those guys had a blast. One team came away with a victory, even better for them.
So that'll just about do it for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to EASports.com. The Broncos are winners as we say so long from Denver.